semester, the University of Minnesota saw a dramatic increase in the number of students seeking help for mental health issues. Our Josh Rosenthal is here now to explain why other campuses across the state are seeing the same thing. Josh.
Ellen, the results from the 2013 College Student Health Survey were released this week. More than 13,000 students from 29 Minnesota schools participated, and the results cover a lot of ground, but the experts are drawing one big conclusion. They say mental health is the number one public health issue at Minnesota colleges and universities. University of Minnesota students can finally exhale.
Not stressed because I finished finals on Tuesday.
Pretty relieved now that finals are done.
Of course, the rest of the year is a different story.
Very stressed.
And stress correlates with depression and anxiety, mental health issues that college campuses across the state are dealing with in startling numbers.
It's happening here. It's happening all across the country.
In the 2013 College Health Survey report, more than 36% of students statewide reported being diagnosed with at least one mental health condition. When the U of M campus, Boynton Mental Health Clinic Director Steve Herman says most years they see a 4 or 5% increase in students seeking help. But last year, they saw a 9% increase. And this semester, they saw a 25% increase.
Mental health issues have become kind of the number one public health issue on college campuses.
Answering why isn't easy. In addition to more stress, Herman thinks there's less of a stigma surrounding mental health than there used to be, and he also points out that Boynton started offering free counseling this year.
It's really important to encourage students who need help to come and get it. And we've tried to lower the barriers for that.
So it's very much a problem without an easy answer. But Herman says the more we talk about it, the better off we'll be. Judging by students we talk to on campus, so far, so good.
I think it's great if people seek out help. There's nothing to be ashamed about. I wish people would talk about it more.
If you'd like to learn more about mental health or find out more about services that might be available to you, we've posted a couple of links for you on our website, KSTP.com. Ellen?
Thanks, Josh. And the survey also covered a few other topics. It found that tobacco use continues to drop at the U of M. Approximately 30% of students engaged in what's called high-risk drinking, defined as consuming 5 or more alcoholic drinks in one sitting. Also, bicycle helmet use is up on campus.